Hi there, my name's Alex Day. I'm head professional here at Dreamland Golf Club, and today we find ourselves on the third hole at Dreamland. We've hit a nice drive. We've left ourselves just over 100 yards left into the green here, but we're faced with a tricky wind. Baku is famous for its wind. It's literally translated as Windy City. And here, despite being quite well sheltered by some of the surrounding villas, I know the breeze is strong today. I can see from the water features here and looking at the clouds. So it's a shot that many golfers will have difficulty with for these reasons. Well, first of all, it comes in the setup. We want to make a change to our ball position to change the launch angle. Rather than having the launch so high, we want to bring that launch angle down a little bit to ensure a more penetrating ball flight. Secondly, we want to reduce the spin rate. If we've got too great amount of spin on the golf ball, that's why it climbs so high. So if we can reduce that spin rate, again, it's going to help us promote a more penetrating ball flight. Okay, so as we mentioned, the first point in producing a more penetrating ball flight when playing into the wind is to create a lower launch angle. How are we going to do that? Well, we're going to try and de-loft this golf club, okay? To do this, we can just simply make a change to our setup. We're going to move that ball position about a ball's width further back in the stance, nearer my lead foot. So for this particular shot, 100 yards, I'd normally be playing my sand wedge with a ball position that's fairly central. What we're in fact now going to do is move that ball position back, as we've said, but keep the hands in the same position they are for a normal shot. So what we've got is a little bit of shaft lean, okay? And what we're furthermore, is just get a bit more weight, a touch more weight on this lead foot, about 60%. The natural tendency for a lot of golfers is when they move that ball position back, when they swing, they try and find it and move back. So to ensure that we're keeping forward, we're creating a lower launch angle, you're going to feel a little bit more weight on this lead side, those hands forward at address, and that will help produce that lower launch. Second point is to reduce the spin rate. Like I said, a lot of golfers, they try and hit the ball too hard, generate too much speed, that generates too much spin, the ball climbs high. So to reduce the spin rate, it's just a case of swinging slower. The old adage from Sam Snead, I think it was, when it's breezy, swing it easy. So you're just going to take a little bit of speed off that club head, but then to counteract that, we're going to club up. So as opposed to taking my sand iron, we'd maybe look at a pitching wedge, 9-iron, depending on the severity of that wind or breeze. Based on those points we've discussed, we're going to get rid of the sand iron. Move that over there, and we're going to take the 9-iron. We are going to, first of all, move that ball position a little further back. We're going to favour the lead foot in terms of my weight distribution. We're at 60% on there. And then in terms of the swing itself, it's a smooth, slower swing, just trying to reduce that spin rate. Okay, it's come out pretty well. It's just found the front edge. Hope you enjoyed that. Check out the full video on Worldwide Golf, and we hope to see you here at Dreamland in the not too distant future. Thanks for watching.